Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In this lesson, you're going to learn the ways that we can tell if two triangles are congruent. The things you'll learn in this lesson are going to be super important in the next few lessons and in our proofs unit. So there's no more time to waste. Let's jump right in. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to determine whether two triangles are congruent and write congruence statements to describe them. First, we'll learn each of the triangle congruence theorems individually, and then you'll complete an example problem in your notes template, similar to what you'll see in the practice game. You're going to learn about 5 triangle congruence theorems in this lesson. We'll begin with the side angle side triangle congruence theorem, and then work our way to all the others. Now, this may seem like a lot of theorems to learn, but once you go through the first few, you'll quickly get the hang of it. The first triangle congruence theorem that we're going to look at is the side-angle-side congruence theorem. It states that if two sides and the included angle of one triangle are congruent to two sides and the included angle of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. That may seem confusing, so let's use a visual to help us break this down. Let's start with this section. It says, two sides and the included angle of one triangle. Here are two sides, and the included angle is the angle where those two sides meet. Then it says, are congruent to two sides and the included angle of another triangle. Well, here's the other triangle, and it has two sides that are congruent to two sides on the first triangle, and its included angle is also congruent to the first triangle's included angle. And remember, the theorem is called side angle side because this second triangle has to have congruences that match the first triangle in that order. A side matches, then rotating around an angle matches, and then one more side. Therefore, according to our theorem, these triangles are congruent. Another way to think of this is that the triangles are exact copies of each other. If one was placed on top of the other, they would overlap perfectly. Now that we've established that these triangles are congruent, we need to write a congruence statement. A congruence statement is a way to communicate to others that our triangles are congruent and exactly which parts in each triangle are congruent to each other. Our statement will have two triangle symbols in it and a congruence symbol. We fill in these blanks with letters from each triangle. Now, the placement of our letters is very important, so follow along extra closely with me. Let's say I choose to put letter A from the first triangle here. Then which letter from my second triangle would need to go here? Do you see how vertex A is between the side with one red marking and the side without a marking at all? Well, what vertex on the other triangle is also between the side with one red marking and the side with no marking at all? It's vertex D. So that has to go first here. Now, it is up to you which order you put your letters, as long as the letters you write for the second triangle are written in the correct order to correspond to the first triangle. So, do you want to write B or C next? Well, it doesn't really matter, but I'm going to guess that you chose B and put that here. Then, what would we need to put here from our second triangle to correspond to this B? Vertex B is between the side with one marking and the side with two markings. Which vertex in our second triangle has that same placement? Right, it's vertex E. Now we just need to fill in our final vertex from each triangle. The first triangle still needs vertex C, and that corresponds to vertex F in the second triangle. And there we have it. This is our congruence statement with the theorem we used to justify it. The next triangle congruence theorem we're going to look at is the side-side-side congruence theorem. It states that if three sides of a triangle are congruent to three sides of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. Let's use a visual again to help us break this down. This phrase says three sides of a triangle are congruent to three sides of another triangle. That's exactly what we have here. According to our theorem, that is enough to say that the triangles are congruent. And now that we've established that the triangles are congruent, can you write a congruence statement on your own? Pause the video now to catch up on any notes and write a congruence statement for these triangles. The first thing we can always start our congruence statement with is two triangles and a congruence symbol. Then we just need to put the corresponding vertices from each triangle in corresponding parts of the statement. I'm going to go through one option for the congruence statement. Remember that yours might not match mine, but they still need to portray the same information. I put vertex E first, so I have to put vertex M first in the second triangle. How do we know those are corresponding vertices of the two triangles? Well, vertex E is between the segments with 3 marks and 2 marks. And the same is true for vertex M. Next, I chose to put vertex G in this triangle. Vertex G is between the sides with 1 marking and 2 markings, and since the same is true for vertex L, I had to write vertex L in the corresponding position of the congruence statement. Then we write the vertex that's remaining from each triangle to finish our statement and write our reason to justify it. So far, we've gone through two of the congruence theorems. These are the next two theorems you get to learn. There's one important difference between these two theorems that you need to keep in mind. Both of these theorems state that there must be two angle congruences shared between the triangles, but the angle-side-angle theorem specifically states that the side must be included between the two angle congruences. So, do you see the side on each triangle that would be considered the included side? Were you thinking of these sides as the included sides since they were between the marked angles? If these had congruence symbols, then we'd use the angle-side-angle congruence theorem to state that these triangles are congruent. We would have angle-angle-side congruence if we were using either of the other sides. Okay. That's all the background information you need to fill in the next two congruence theorems in your notes template. I'm going to leave these two sections up to you, so pause the video now and work through them yourself. Let's check your work to make sure your notes are correct. Remember, if you made a mistake, take the time you need to fully understand it before moving on. You may also have a different congruence statement than the key has, but as long as the corresponding parts are lined up in the statement, you are correct. So pause the video now to go through this key. Now that you are comfortable with the first four triangle congruence theorems, let's learn about the hypotenuse leg triangle congruence theorem. This will be the final theorem to fill in your notes template. Now's the time to see what predictions you can make about this theorem. If there's a few blanks you can't seem to figure out in your notes template, don't worry, but pause the video now and see what you can fill in on your own. Okay, let's see how it went. Go ahead and check your work with this key. Remember, don't speed through this part, and be sure that your congruence statement has A in the same place as D, and so forth. Pause the video now to check this over. Now that you know the triangle congruence theorems, it's time to practice an example at your own pace by finishing your notes template for this lesson. Once you've done that, check with an adult and the key for any additional explanation you may need. Then, complete the practice game. See you next time.